Hello and welcome to another exciting episode of Token Games Podcast. I'm your host and sometimes referee, and today I'm joined by Fiona, who's going to be texting in, Pika Datmitsu.
I'm holding a big shield, and I just got an icicle in the ass.
Not touching that one. And, of course, Haven Dat Morris.
I'm the one to put the icicle there.
Then it's probably not an icicle if it's shaped like a penis. Moving on, today's topics, however brief they may be, are segmented to try to sort of digest people into getting into podcasts, or rather just for the sake of efficiency. We're going to start off with our more pop culture end this time, because even though we say we do pop culture, we do a little too heavy on the gaming side. So our first segment will be TV shows that we feel don't get enough attention. And we're going to start with you, Haven. Whilst I eat this cheesecake with a motherfucking spoon.
Bitch, eat it with your goddamn hands like everybody else.
No, you can be quiet.
Savage ass motherfucker.
Also, no, if it's cold enough, you can eat it with your hands. And that's how you do it like a man. If you eat it anywhere else, you're not a man.
If it's directly cold enough. The only thing the only reason it's going to get cold enough is if you put that thing in the freezer when you get it home. Putting it in the fridge is not enough.
That's a cheesecake sickle at that point.
All I know is graham cracker crust. But the TV shows I have watched recently that are not anime was the Arrow for the DC. Whatever, and then Flash, which was also, and they're both pretty good, better than most of DC movies in my opinion, which is saying not that much.
Yeah, I mean they set the bar pretty low.
And then I've watched a lot of Doctor Who in my time. Doctor Who is the shit. Actually went back and watched Doctor Who in the Time of the Angels. Weeping Angels are the scariest shit on this earth.
What the fuck is that? Is that like a special or some shit?
No, it's just two episodes where Doctor Who gets the faces off against the Weeping Angels, which is an organism that resembles that statue of a Weeping Angel until you turn your back, and then it's like a living embodiment of evil, and either will snap your neck or send you back in time and eat up your lifespan's time. Either way, very not good.
Yeah, that's actually pretty creepy. Also, that's cheap as fuck as far as the villain goes.
I mean, it's the scariest fucking villain I've ever seen in all time. As long as you're looking at it, it can't move. Well, technically, they cease to exist when you look at them, but when you look away or you blink, they can move, and they're supposedly stronger, the strongest thing in the universe. Plus, they can send you back in time. So that's kind of fucked up.
Yeah.
But they go from looking like this defenseless little statue, and then they turn into, like, this fucking horrible demon. It's just, it's the thing of nightmares, bro.
All right, what about you, Coleman?
Well, since I don't have cable in the house,
motherfucker, you got Netflix.
I'm sorry, what was that?
I said, motherfucker, you got Netflix.
No, I don't have Netflix.
Would you like Netflix?
We'll talk after the show.
Okay.
At any rate, there is a show that I've caught when I was at work. It's on NBC. It's one of the newest game shows out. It's called The Wall. And it's co-produced, get this, by LeBron James.
Oh, God.
Which is pretty interesting. Now, I'm guessing you guys have watched The Price is Right at one time in your lives.
And I'm also watching this carrot cake in my mouth. Go ahead.
Anyways, you do remember the game Plinko, right?
Yeah.
Okay, imagine Plinko, except it's on a huge-ass fucking, like, 40-foot wall. And instead of dropping little Plinko chips down, you basically drop like soccer ball sized balls down this thing. And instead of winning like up to maybe $10,000 or $25,000, you can win up to $1 million with one ball. You can win a lot of money in this show. And it's, but the thing is, it's based on couples, and there's a lot of in-depth to it. I'd say, like, go on the NBC site, check out an episode of The Wall, see if you like it. It's really underrated at this point. I don't hear too many people talk about it, but it's a really interesting show.
It's because it's for old people with nothing better to do in the morning. Anyways.
Oh, this is at night. This show's at, like, I believe 10 p.m., either 9 or 10 p.m. at night.
Damn, and they're struggling for an audience at that point. Anyways.
I don't know. Blame LeBron. I'm pretty sure he had a hand in picking what time comes on.
Okay. Haven, if you'd be so kind as to read Fiona's first question.
Okay, so, This one is tricky, seeing as I don't really watch TV, unless you count kid shows. I really, really can't stand kid shows.
There's more to it.
Oh, and then she said something about the carrot cake. Oh. For a carrot cake, I would do a ginger snap crust, cookie crust. And then her reply to do Weeping Angel is the perfect being. And they sent, according to Doctor Who logic, they send you back in time and make you relive your life before you were born, only to die on the day you vanished. Of old age, don't judge me.
Okay. Well, in my case, I got a few shows, but I'm going to narrow that shit down. The first one being fucking Black Mirror, man. Fucking Black Mirror. All right, so who here knows what the Twilight Zone is? Nobody? Wow, that's fucked up. All right, yeah. So a long, long time ago.
She says me.
Okay, well, I still have to explain it because we got some young bastards in here trying to make me feel old. Even though one of you is older than me. Fucking The Twilight Zone is basically the first show produced, or one of the first shows ever to be produced in any country, let alone America, that tried to do phenomena thriller or phenomena horror. As in, something scary happens, but you have no control over it. And half the time, you don't know how or why it's happening. You just know that it's happening. For an example, one person can't get a doll to stop talking. So he throws the doll away. The doll shows back up. He tries to cut the doll. The doll is cut-proof, bulletproof, fireproof, all this shit. He can't figure out how to make the doll stop, so he kills himself. Now, there's a slight twist on shit like that with Black Mirror. Black Mirror is basically the Twilight Zone of the future. And I mean, it's trying to basically show us what 50 years in the future might look like in the worst possible fucking way. For example, there is one episode where we find out people are born with the ability to have their entire library of memories and events recorded and watch them directly on their eyeball. One dude didn't hate this feature, but he soon realized that his wife fucked his best friend by watching her display onto a television screen her memories, and that the child she's having might not even be his. But that only happened because of that. But he got so fed up with it, the minute he did it, he fucking literally dug a hole where it was put inside of his head and pulled it the hell out. He lost his home. He divorced his wife. But at least he doesn't have to raise a kid that's not his own, because she wasn't even going to fucking tell him. And then in the first episode, arguably one of the worst and most frightening episodes, somebody used technology to blackmail the goddamn Prime Minister of Britain into fucking a pig because he kidnapped his daughter. Crazy. It sounds sick, but it's only sick when you realize that, holy shit, this type of a future could actually happen. because they make it so plausible. It's frightening. So yeah, on to segment two, or I guess topic two. Still can't decide, should I say segment or topic? Anyways, gaming news. Not just what I think and find, but also what you guys want to talk about, if y'all even have anything. Okay, so my thing is, the shit that pissed me off with GameStop, as if I haven't already talked enough shit about them. Guess what these mugs did with a small increase in Nintendo Switch surpluses that they get? They put these bitches up for a fucking lottery in the stores, and they only got 1,000. So if you went in there, Coleman, and the GameStop employee knew that they had a Switch that they could let you reserve, they could say fuck it, because they didn't get pinged to let them know, hey, the next customer that comes in and asks them about it, let them get it. And even then, they don't know if the next customer is going to ask. So basically, the goddamn individual retail employee has final say-so on if you can reserve a Switch, not time and place. And they're doing this at 1,000 locations with 1,000 Switches. They basically just turned this shit into fucking bingo night. And it aggravates the fuck out of me. Coleman, feelings?
It's bullshit, to be honest.
Yep.
They're playing with something that so many people want, and they're cheating it like a fucking lottery scratch-off card.
Yeah.
It's absolute bullshit. That's why I think about it. And the thing is, this lottery, it's not even to fucking, like, be able to win one. It's to pre-order one.
Yep.
It's absolutely fucked up.
Haven?
Hey, all I can say is, if you punch the guy in the mouth, he can't tell you no.
What the fuck?
Just reach across and punch the guy in the mouth. You know, if he's threatened physically enough, he'll reserve you anything. Especially a GameStop employee, because they're all bitches.
Well, those are your words, not mine. But yeah, it is kind of fucked up about the whole shit that happened last week that I honestly wanted to talk about too, where GameStop fucking sent out a letter to their employees saying, hey, if you don't sell more fucking used games than you do new games, you're going to get fired eventually. And then the fucking CEO, my favorite part was the CEO's response, we would never condone something like, motherfucker, it came from you. Even if it didn't come from you,
they tell their GameStop employees to lie.
Yeah, my favorite one is when people somehow get a year subscription to Game Informer and they don't know it. I know three people
that still haven't received the GameStop Game Informer since I have a subscription.
Oh, it's because
she says she hates GameStop, honestly.
Yeah, dude, it's because you got set up for a digital subscription. That's how they were getting away with it. People assume that the email is spam or junk about, hey, since you stopped at GameStop and GameStop owns Game Informer, we want to try to get you to buy our magazine. Nope, it's the actual magazine. They don't realize because they got it set to spam. You got a fucking account.
Yeah, no, I have that shit set to physical, and I've not received one ever. I received my first like 12, and then it was just like, nope, you don't get them anymore.
Dude, you have to renew it
just
every
like,
12
I don't
months.
Care.
You have to renew it every 12 months.
I do, with my subscription.
Well, then you need to just tell them. Or go to digital. Set it to digital and tell them you're missing the shit.
You know what they told me last time?
Tough titty.
That somebody was that the mailman was stealing them. I was like, why would the mailman steal my Game Informers?
Yeah, what especially since purpose? It's a felony and he would go to fucking jail. Lying ass motherfuckers. Well, we already know how Fiona feels about it. She fucking hates GameStop, and to be honest, I don't think I even have a reason to shop there anymore, other than the fact that they're pretty much buying all the amiibos if you're not a major retailer they're getting the amiibos. So play and trade, mom and pop stores, they're either not getting amiibos or they're fucking just not even trying to reserve amiibos. So if I want to get a Legend of Zelda amiibo, I got to go to a physical store, because I already know it's going to be the same situation as it was with the game, with the controllers and the Nintendo Switch. That shit going to be off of fucking Amazon in like 17, 15 minutes. I shit you not. Amazon ran out of Nintendo Switch accessories. Accessories 15 minutes after they went up. Not just one Amazon, all the Amazons. So if I want to get my Legend of Zelda, I'm on a motherfucking horse. Take a look at me, amiibo, for Breath of the Wild. I got to go into a GameStop. But when I'm not doing that, fuck them. Anyways. All right, Coleman, you got any local gaming news you want to talk about?
Doomfist may be coming soon, and I really hope that it's voiced by Terry Crews.
I think it's either going to be Terry Crews or The Rock.
Yes, yes, yes. Fuck The Rock. It's Terry Crews. Fuck The Rock right now.
Yeah, The Rock, I gotta admit, after he finished up with his wrestling days, he's gotten himself a lot of
money,
nice movie roles, like whether it be just like animated or like live action. But as far as voiceover stuff is concerned, his animated voiceover stuff, it's basically been all kids stuff, man. Like, this is an adult game. We need a grown man in order to do this, and I couldn't think of anyone better than Terry Crews for this.
Here's what I can't figure out. If they want to keep this shit secret, why the fuck are they just letting people, like, blatantly pretend or go out and snitch? Remember all the bullshit all the fans went through with Sombor theories? I actually like watching y'all do that. I wasn't about to do any of that, but I like watching the YouTube videos about it. And then here comes Sacred saying, hey, you guys want me to be Doomfist? I want to be Doomfist. Even though we don't know shit about this motherfucker, other than the fact that there were three people who were Doomfist before. And then my personal favorite, oh, he just goes and stands in front of the logo on the wall on the building. I'm like, dude, are you supposed to be snitching? If you actually are, in fact, Doomfist, what if you were Doomfist Jr. or Doomfist Light and someone's going to precede you? I mean, look how long they kept fucking the fact that Tracer was a lesbian a secret. Yes, people who didn't already know that, living under a rock, even though the internet cared way too much because it didn't really do shit. Tracer is, in fact, a goddamn lesbian. You know what else? Zangief is gay. Anyways. So, what about you, Haven?
I ain't got none.
Okay, Fiona, you got any gaming news you want to talk about, discuss, or just bring up?
Other than that, gaming's, you know, pretty quiet. We're going to wait for the beginning of next month to get some decent games coming out. We'll see what happens.
Go ahead.
Absolutely bullshit is going to hurt GameStop. I think 2017 is the year of boycotting stupid things. Okay. I hate GameStop, honestly.
Read number two from the top.
I haven't been looking for news, but I don't find the E3 is opening to the public this year.
No, she did.
Which is cool. Hey, I'm reading this. You stay over there.
Yes, ma'am.
Which is cool. I've been following what's been sent, but that's got to be all I've got. And now she's typing again. XD. Ha, 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 ha.
What the fuck?
Yes.
No, that's someone
rebel,
else.
Revel in my stupidity.
No. So apparently, no one told her that you were reading off Fiona's responses, so now his voice is pillow talk. What the fuck?
Yes, baby, yes.
I always just assumed your voice was a head cold, but okay. To each his own. I don't judge, unless it's funny. Okay, Well, I guess we can move on to part three unless anybody else got some other news. Oh, yeah. Well, I kind of brought it up already. The fucking Nintendo Switch accessory sold out in 15 goddamn minutes on Amazon. Holy shit. On to segment three. Video games in 2017 have a chance of evolution or revolution, or a possible continued decline due to excessive extortion, or for short... Video games in 2017 have a chance of having either a revolution or evolution to stave off the continued decline in sales due to excessive... But is the decline due to excessive extortion? The economy not so much being in the shitter as it is people being more fiscally responsive? This is a recreational hobby, after all. But how can the industry turn around the continued sales slump of video games specifically? And I'm going to start with Haven because he made a noise.
Okay. Well, you know, people could stop being assholes. And, you know, we could all just go ahead and... God damn it, people talking in my ear. I said we can go ahead and get ready to experience a cultural renaissance where everybody just comes together. Man, shut the fuck up. I'm trying to talk. So look, if we come together and that, and the whole community just goes and comes together, I don't know. I'm just bullshitting right now. I don't know anything.
Okay, well, let me help you out a little bit. I wanted to compress the question, but I realize now that I've done it, you know, that alienates people if they weren't following the issue directly. Okay, so video games make more money every year. This is true. But video game sales and money earned are not in sync, as we all know. That disconnect is due to stuff like DLC, season passes, blah, 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 blah. Also, it even affects the system market. Now, I don't have the chart in front of me, and I'm pretty sure somebody can Google it, but if you Googled or looked up the actual physical sales chart of systems produced, the decline is every single console cycle. Meaning that basically from, we'll say the Super Nintendo, or rather the PS2 PlayStation era downwards, physical sales go down of consoles year after year, or 5 year after 5 year, because you know how these console cycles are. Of course, the handhelds are the exception to the rule because there's really only one in the fucking market. But that aside, that doesn't match up with the money that we're making because of DLC. For instance, who here knew that last year, Destiny alone made as much and a little bit more money in DLC sales as Valve. Yes, that Valve. They made as much money as Steam has. And a little bit more. Just off of Destiny. Crazy, isn't it? Yeah. So basically, my question is, how do we adjust that slump? Is there any ways to fix it? How can we get video game and console sales to go back up? And I specifically mean video game and consoles. Not PC games, not PC ports, not indie titles. Unless, you know, the indie title is a physical video game, blah, 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 blah. So, Haven, we'll come back to you. What are your feelings, Mr. Coleman?
So, we're saying console sales are down? That's just basically a general wrap-up of things? I mean, because if it's just console sales, this is a given. Once a console's been out for so long, those numbers are just going to gradually dip. Maybe if a hot game comes out, maybe a few more people will pick up that console. But unless people, you know, like, say, fuck taking my broken console and, like, shipping it to the, you know, the major company, whether it be Microsoft or Sony, or waiting 6 to 8 goddamn weeks to get it back and just buying a new one, I just think that these numbers will continually dip until, you know, the next generation comes out. That people are acting like this is some sort of new trend and, oh my god, it's the end of the world.
Bullshit.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Dropping something there?
No, I agree with you. Like, you're absolutely right. Like, when it comes to a recreational market, not to interrupt you, but I'm agreeing with you. When it comes to a recreational market of any product, like, whether it's sores or shits, is based on, one, is it actually entertaining? And two, do people have the money for it?
Right. And, you know, some people will have to save up for a bit. Some people have to wait for a sale. When those sales hit, you'll get a little bit more out of it. But other than that, whoever's got it is basically got it. Something major, you know, unless something major happens, it's not going to change their mind. You know, unless something absolutely, like, cataclysmic changes in the market, this will happen with every new generation of consoles. And I honestly don't see a way to stop the general decline, because it's just a way of life, man.
Oh, that was a bit abysmal, but I appreciate your honesty. Now, that being said, Haven, go ahead and scroll up and read Fiona's response.
Okay. A good way to turn the sales around is to probably see what's more popular and work from there instead of releasing junk. Not sequels, not remarks, unique, amazing ideas, and without sequels, with a wide variety of system allowance. DLC is bullshit. It's gouging sales from people, and that's stupid. More costume variety than new characters or extra content, that you can't have original. BS is serious.
Okay. Well, Fiona detests DLC. Ironically, DLC existed a long, long time ago. It just didn't become console applicable till fairly recently. And we've somehow managed to fuck that shit up. Well, I might as well go into my opinion, because Haven doesn't seem to have one, supposedly. My feelings are a bit of a mixed bag. As you all know or don't care about, I've been on multiple sides of this issue, but to varying degrees. I'm a general manager of a retailer, so I can understand why new games don't want to be sold at a retailer, but at the same time, I'm also a consumer, so I can understand why companies want to get money off of these new game sales. And I can understand that, you know, they want to get fucking, you know, money off of a used game sale that they're not getting, and almost nobody really is. So your next best bet is to do expansions and DLC. But at the same time, these big companies have to worry about overlords fucking telling them to make DLC that gets some extra money that doesn't trickle down. Because much like the company, much like the country, even though trickle-down economics works, it doesn't work if the person who's got the stuff to trickle ain't letting the shit flow down. Let me tell you something. You could work, and this has happened, you could work on a game every day, have all of your off days removed from you for 6-7 months, have the game fucking legitimately go out of its way to fucking just master that shit down. Make sure that you don't need no type of day one patching bullshit. And even if you sold 2 million copies, depending on how much effort and time went into it, there's a chance you still couldn't make your money back. Because remember, you're not just selling it in one area. You're selling it in pretty much every region where that console is. Shit costs money, as it were. So what is your next best bet? DLC, season passes, expansion packs. Here's the thing, though. That's been going on in the PC world forever. Also, I don't know who the fuck came up with this whole PC Master Race bullshit, but that shit need to go. Because the first problem it always happens with a PC game is that it needs a patch. You'll never get a guaranteed game to go and start from beginning to end. Even if you do, it doesn't mean the next person will. That problem is all but erased from the video game world, which is another reason why, even though PCs have been stronger than us forever, we've never been destroyed or erased. And also, I don't even understand why the fuck there's even a goddamn fight. Literally, I don't understand why there's a fight. No one ever said, oh, well, video games are prettier and stronger. No one ever, and no one probably ever will.
PC is not the master race.
This is true, Fiona. This is very true. But at the end of the day, that's why I can understand it. And then also, when you're on the indie side of things, you have to know distribution, or at least understand distribution enough to figure out what can and can't make you a profit, or what you might have to do at a loss and whatnot. Of course, I'm still working on my first title, but even before that, I made sure I knew how to work. I made sure I knew everything I need to know about distribution and virtual console shits. And the fact that I'm a general manager now of an entertainment software retailer just compounds on that shit. If I spend $100,000 on my game and my game makes back $60,000 and is critically acclaimed, I'm fucked. You know why? Because for me to make $60,000 back means I've sold a shit ton of my game new. But if, say, 10% of those people were going to buy or willing to buy DLC I make every time I make it, and even if the DLC is cheap, I have a chance of making my money back. Or rather, making more money than the assholes who are selling my used game. Of course, that's not really ever going to happen, that last part, but it's entirely what they're banking on. They are getting more money with DLC because they know even if only 5 to 10%, there'll always be somebody who's classified as a whale. This is an actual thing that they do. This is an actual business term. A whale is someone who is willing to spend more on a game or more on your product than they feasibly should, even if it hurts their wallet or their financial standing. Not even joking. They actually call them whales. They even have them in the gambling world too. So we all get, just for shits and giggles, Fire Emblem Heroes, that new cell phone game that Nintendo made. Now, that game has a built-in stamina gauge. Basically, it's one of their ways they're trying to make sure, you know, you don't blow your whole fucking load on this and end up being homeless or out in the street. I like the game. I might play the game once or twice a week because I know it's a game with no end, or at least not for the foreseeable future. It's going to have an end to it. But Fiona could go and fall in love with the game and try to turn into a human being and marry the shit. She could drop $700 a month. And then Haven could like the game and never spend a goddamn dime, but still end up with more shit, yes, pretty much, but still end up with more shit in the game than all of us, because he put in more time than me and Fiona combined, and Coleman, who is, and we'll say he plays the game just for the sake of argument. But the whale is where the money comes from. And since Fiona's the whale, they want to keep her and have her spending as long and for as much as possible. But that also harms another section. Fuck, pretty much it's a lose-lose for everybody unless you're GameStop. And they should be losing. It harms the fucking game industry in the sense that there's less incentive for a sequel. So instead of a sequel being based on good ideas and a quality product, it could be based on, our hundreds of millions of dollars that we were getting suddenly dropped into the double-digit millions instead of the triple-digit millions. Oh, time to make a sequel. And that's one of the reasons why an independent developer might become obsessed with DLC. Not because he loves money and it'll upgrade his life and he's a greedy bitch. They do exist, make no mistake. But also because he wouldn't have to worry about getting to his next title as much. So, in summary, I guess the best way I can put it is DLC is a necessary evil, but it doesn't have to be evil. The problem is that there are a lot of companies and a lot of people who work for these companies who are too comfortable with extorting and fucking up the market. And it sucks. Anybody else want to add anything on that topic?
Nope.
Okay.
Right.
Okay. Well, I guess I can put us in our little final stretch, leg stretch of this little thing, which is what you been playing. And we're going to start with Fiona because her response was funny. Or segment four, what have you been playing? She's going to say Justice League MMO because she somehow got re-addicted on an MMO that fucking caps you at level 30.
DC Universe Online, don't judge me. I've been addicted to it again.
Of course I'm going to judge you. It's an MMO where the fucking level cap has been 30 for 3 goddamn years. And to top it off, you can't even actually get or learn all the classes. You can't even pick one. You can only pick like 4 or 5, and the rest you have to pay to be that class. That is the biggest load of shit I have ever... That's actually one of the reasons I stopped fucking playing. It wasn't because I didn't find the game enjoyable. No, I was enjoying myself. The combat was ass, but it was serviceable. But it was because you can't stop what you're doing, delete your character, and make a new one if you want to try out a new class or reclass. No, you just have to buy the ability to even get the class. That's what pissed me off.
Well, that's happened a lot with a lot of MMOs, but...
No.
DC Universe is really not that fun because, you know, I have it on PC and Xbox, but the Xbox, you have to wait so long to get in the damn server. You might as well buy the premium edition. So your wait can be like, what, 2-3 minutes? I know one time I tried to log in and it was like 48 hours to get into a server, and I was like, ha! you gotta be kidding me. So I promptly downloaded it from my Xbox, and I went on to bigger and better things.
Hey, Fiona.
The lag sucks sometimes, and what the fuck, just to get into the server? Yes, Fiona, just to get into the server.
Hey, Fiona, you do realize that with $20, you can do a lot of damage as far as used games go for the PlayStation 3. I know you haven't played God Hand. And all the new BlazBlue games price drops so fast on the PS3, it's not even funny. The last one that came out 2 years ago, yeah, that last BlazBlue on the PS3, that one used is like $8. $8. And the new one that came out on PS4 and PS3, that one, that shit is like 25, 35 used. But God Hand is like 10. Also, even though the fucking Wii version is better, No More Heroes has a remake on the PS3 called No More Heroes Paradise. It's like $12, Fiona. Go get it. Even if you don't have those really stupid PlayStation wands that can be hooked up with PlayStation VR, the game works with a normal controller. In fact, I'm just going to show you guys a small glimpse of No More Heroes. And why everybody's happy that a new one's coming to the fucking Switch.
They're hurt. Just go on there and finish.
Thank you. This one dude, the first boss, comes at you with a fucking laptop that can transform into a thick ass lightsaber. Craziness. All you do is basically take a Star Wars lightsaber and cut people. But if you had the PlayStation bullshit ass Wiimote imitation or the authentic Wiimote, when you finish their HP off, you can actually cut them in whatever direction you see. And it's a beautiful thing.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah, I dropped the link to the video in chat. What else could you do for a little bit of money on the PS3? Oh, the entire Devil May Cry HD collection is on the fucking PS3. Kinda mad it's not on the PS4. But that being said, that would mean I would have bought the same shit over 5 times. But you know, it's a good thing when the minute you buy it, you're like, why did I do that? I already have it. That means they made a good product. I swear to God, man, if they just went and made Devil May Cry 3 co-op online and not just offline, I don't think I'd leave my house for at least 2 days. Oh yeah, fun fact. If you stick a controller in a second port for Devil May Cry 3, or in a two-player slot, and you put on doppelganger style and press start, you can play the game with two people. Also, when you get to the end of the game, old school spoilers, this is an old game, people, I shouldn't even have to say spoilers. And it's not really a spoiler, but when you get to the, right before the final boss fight, when you team up with your brother, if you press start, that second person is Virgil. And in both cases, the second player has infinite health. So the only one who has to worry about dying is player one. So basically, it's like God mode doppelganger. Beautiful. Anyways, I might just go and play that tonight too. Anyways, so yeah, there's a lot you can do. Let me just type in DMC HD collection. Okay, somebody need to hit the fucking mute button, Haven.
Hey, why am I having to hit the mute button?
Because it sounds like you're washing dishes and shit. Anyways, so yeah, we'll see what we got here. Coleman, closing statements?
I just rammed me into a wrong wall. Oh, fuck me running. I'm good.
Yeah, he plays Overwatch during these and he says random shit that I can't follow half the time. Haven, closing statements? Did Haven get disconnected?
I don't think so. He might have muted himself or he may have walked away.
Eat a dick.
Okay, Eric Cartman. Yeah, I'm scared to ask Fiona for closing statements.
What?
Nah, I'm just waiting for Fiona to type her closing statements. Hopefully, I won't regret it.
She is typing on my fucking keyboard.
I seriously doubt that she can't just like pop outside or something or go into a basement without there being a shit ton of noise.
Black Hills, DLC, while necessary in this day is stupid. Now games are stupid these days. GameStop is stupid. Ta-ra! Ta-da! Yes.
I think she said new games are stupid these days, but okay. Fair enough. This has been another exciting episode of Token Games Podcast. See you guys when I see you, motherfuckers.